Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and interfaith. Here I present a discourse on the chosen people and the promised land. This is part two. Thus, God gave Joseph wisdom, which his other dishonest and selfish brothers and arrogant father were denied of. And at the same time, the promised land of honey and milk turned barren as the sons of Jacob had become disloyal to God. Further, the story of starving brethren of Joseph going to Egypt, the land of Arabs, loyal to God. Remember the story of prodigal son? The elder son was loyal to God and he had plenty to eat. To buy, beg for food, and the generosity of Joseph that reflected the hospitality and wisdom of Abraham in Ishmael is well known to us. On the other hand, the Arabs continued to love people through hospitality and kept on enjoying the blessings of God in terms of the abundance of food. The above facts Jesus summarized in the parable of prodigal son, Luke 15:11-32. In this parable, father is God, the elder son are the descendants of Ishmael, the Arabs, Samaritans and Gentile, whilst the younger prodigal son are the descendants of Isaac, called Jews. The suffering of Jews in Egypt is compared to the son eating food that is given to pigs. That is a food of the lowest quality that they never had to eat in Israel when they were loyal to God. Their repentance is the 40 years stay in the wilderness when Moses looked after them, and their return to the lush green promised land is compared to the killing of the fattened calf. This parable also gives us a lesson that in God, unlike in Moses, a person has a free will either to leave him and suffer at the hands of Satan or stay with him, humble and enjoy his blessings. So also the people have a free will in Jesus. This faithfulness and unfaithfulness to God by the descendants of Isaac and Ishmael is further reflected in the stories relating to the sacrifices of Abraham, Ishmael and Abraham, Isaac's. In the Abraham-Ishmael story, there is a mention of the repulsion of Satan by Ishmael before God presented to them a ram for sacrifice and rejoicing. Whereas in the Abraham-Isaac story, there is no mention of the repulsion of Satan because unlike Ishmael, the people of Isaac, being the Jews of flesh, were already the sons of Satan and not of God. Therefore, no ram could be presented to Abraham-Isaac, and this is depicted in the promised land becoming barren. And this is a typical example of the corruption of the holy books, analogized and analogized by Jesus to the old cloth, the written holy books developing holes, which cannot be patched with the brand new cloth, but they are repairable through the knowledge of gospel. That is, Jesus came to fulfill the law, but not to destroy it. The key to understand the criterion of faithfulness and unfaithfulness to God lies in the saying, a Jew is one who is inwardly mean of the spirit, and not outwardly of the flesh or in tribe. The Jew is not a tribe, it's a spiritual self, never born, never die. Thus, the descendants of Isaac, when they become the Jews of flesh, that means unfaithful to Abraham, through the circumcision of flesh and of the birth of a Jewish woman who has no seed, then they are unfaithful to God. Whilst when they become Jews of spirit through the circumcision of their hearts, then they become faithful to God. Thomas Logos 53. His disciples, which are in fact the workers, said to him, "Is circumcision beneficial or not?" He said to them, "If it were beneficial, their father would beget them already circumcised from their mother. Rather, the true circumcision in spirit has become completely profitable, because this dark age is the age of spirit, and no more of the ritual or works, or as it was in previous ages. Thus, most of the present Jews of flesh who claim Israel to be the country of Jews, and they normally talk in such terms as the Jewish race, the Jewish settlements, etc., are the people who are unfaithful to Abraham, whereas the faithful to God Jews of spirit always talk in terms of the tribal identity of the flesh. Thus, in the Revelation, the people who will be saved are clearly mentioned in terms of the tribes, the sons of Adam, and not as the Jews. Jesus called the sons of Adam as the salt of the earth, and those who were Jews of the flesh and not of the heart, they called them saltless people who had no conscience. And it is also worth stressing that the Hajj rites are in honor of Abraham, who earned the title of father of the faithful. But at present, these spiritual rites have completely lost their significance. In short, the Hajj is for entry into the realm of Islam, but not for the so-called Muslims. So, Hajj, it's the temple of Adam, Kaaba, and in India we call this a Shiv or Mahadev. So, this temple of Adam is well known to the Mohammedans, but they go there for Hajj, and originally it was for 12 to 16 years old boys only, not for the girls. You remember John the Baptist, he never baptized a woman, so he baptized men in the name of Abraham. So here also the Hajj, this is 12 to 16 years boys which go there to establish their covenant with their tribal father, and there used to be about more than 370 idols, statues, which was called Illah. Illah means tribal gods. And Al-Illah means our father in, the father in spirit, which is Allah or God. Allah and God mean the same thing. So at present, these people go to Hajj. They are grown up, they are women, they are children. Anything can go, there. And it has become more like a business. So this is a good example of religion is the opium for masses. And there's no doubt about it. And same is a Christianity, Sikhism. Everything has turned the same level, opium for the masses. They don't understand what it means, what is spiritual self is. They always talk, so many Sikhs die, so many Hindus dies. How can a Hindu die or a Sikh die when he was not born? Spiritual self is never born, never die. It's the tribal self which is born and which dies. And this land, our planet, is for the habitation of the sons of Adam, not of God. So unless you become son of man, you cannot be son of God. So let's go to part 3 now. Thank you.